Leonardo da Vinci was an artist, architect, engineer, and scientist during the Renaissance. One of his more renowned works is the painting of the Mona Lisa. This painting is currently on display in the Louvre in France. Though he is known for his paintings, he actually considered himself more of a scientist and cataloged his works in his sketchbooks here. His inventions were way ahead of his time, and he's still considered a genius today. When I visited the Uffizi in Florence, Italy, I actually took this photo of his unfinished Adoration of the Magi, which is the inspiration for our work today. I look around and find hues in my pantry, like this bright yellow turmeric, this warm curry, and some spicy red cayenne pepper. I went ahead and got a little bit creative. I brewed an Earl Grey tea, a green tea, and let's be real, that's my coffee from this morning. My spices I put in a little watercolor palette. You can use a plate or whatever you have on hand, and you really don't need that much. What you're gonna do is take a brush, and you're gonna dab a little bit of the spice, we're gonna call it a pigment, a little bit of your pigment into the water. Now before I began, I went ahead and experimented with my different pigments. So you can see here that I have my coffee, my teas, and my spices labeled so I can get a nice idea of my value range before I begin. This is a sketch I did earlier. This is actually something that most people consider to be a self-portrait by Da Vinci, even though it's not labeled as such. I thought it would be appropriate for this project. Now, because I'm mixing these spices in with water, I have to treat it like a watercolor. I kind of made a mistake and started with my darkest value, but really, I need to start with my lightest areas. When you're making a watercolor, the light areas you're going to leave empty. Then you're going to go into the next value, change the lightest value, and layer those on. Underneath the nose, the upper lip, the chin, and underneath the eyes tend to have the most shade. You can even feel where your face curves under with your own hand. The areas where your face curves under is going to have shadow in a drawing or a painting. Right now, this is really shiny and you can see all the water on it. I'm going to let that dry. And next, I'm going to add on my middle range of values. Here's my cayenne to warm it up a bit. For this composition, I do try to balance out the values on each side. So I try and balance out one value on the left side, as well as find somewhere on the right side. Then, in order to make him make sense with the background, I transfer some of those values into my background areas as well. Now, I'm not expecting you guys to go out and do a master artwork or something as detailed as this. This is just what I had on hand. I'm finding those shaded areas, the darkest values now, that upper lip, around the chin. Balance it out with the hair. And when I'm finished with this, I'm still noticing that because I created my own pigments or using these spices, that my value range isn't as extreme as I would like. So I'm gonna let this dry, and then in the finished product, you're gonna see that I went ahead and sketched it out with pen, but really you could use pencil or marker, whatever you have on hand. Please feel free to get creative in this project. I want to see what you guys can come up with.